good with upgrading our weapons.
Goes it, friend.
You again. All right then.
Okay. Acidic jawbone makes a weapon called the gas giant. You now have the technology to have multiple people talk to the same NPC at once.
This better be good.
Yep.
All right, let's see what you've got.
Okay, everything's now 3, and I can get 2 things to 4. So I'll just get my actual guns to 4.
I got a Helix weapon mod.
Yeah.
You got that too?
Yeah, Helix was from the material we got off the ghost dude.
Okay.
And the jawbone is giving us the, whatchamahoos it, the hammer.
Did you get Gas Giant also?
Yeah.
A melee weapon?
That's from the jawbone that we got from the final boss of that world.
Okay. Since I don't have anything on melee, I don't think I'll have one.
It's not a, it's just based on how much scrap you have is all. We can get all of them. But then we have another crafting material. And I'm wondering what that's for. Maybe it's for armor? Because we have the... What's it called? Shining Essence Echo. And it's got the subtitle crafting material.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe it's armor. I'm going to see if it's... This guy's just buy and sell.
Oh, wish can we buy mutators for stuff?
That's what the weird dude is.
Oh.
We might have an umbrella driver. I was actually just walking over to check into. You can also... Oh, yeah. The Corrupted Luminite Crystals is, in fact, for upgrading the things. The mutators as well. And upgrading the Refunder gives an increased chance to get the bullet back.
Yeah.
That one is just such a dope general-purpose one. I think I'm just gonna jam that mofo up. Ooh. The third level requires 2 Corrupted Crystals. Doing it anyway. So that means when it caps out, it's a 35% chance to get a free bullet. That's pretty good. We don't have enough relic dust yet to make a mutator. That's okay.
You must return.
I'm trying to figure out what the spirit is used to craft.
I was sworn one of these guys was actually selling relic dust.
I'm gonna talk to the architect.
What can I do for you, friend? Well, sure! Been cooking all.
We still haven't found any simulacrum to get
the guy. Tell him again, traveler.
No charges.
Rest assured.
Which is unfortunate.
Oh, we actually have enough money to buy some of these rings, too, if you want.
That's cool. True. If we end up in a world that has, like, heavy on an element, having one of those could be good. Unfortunately, Nerud was heavy on an element that those rings don't cover. really cover fire, shock, and corrosion, and we ended up in a blight world. There's also bleed. Those are the only five.
Yep.
We do have enough spare money to buy one of the archetype items. I'm thinking I might buy whatever the one Brandis right, has dear. Is so we can find out
take
what it
care,
is.
Travel.
Okay. And then if you want the medic one, that's the person, there's a doctor person here who sells the medic one.
What you need? Yeah.
Those guns at Bravis.
But Rusty Metal is probably Hunter, I'm guessing. Now that I have the item.
Back again, Trapped. Knock yourself out.
I bet it's probably expensive to craft it, but
let's see. Okay, so you're thinking I buy the metal pin?
Yeah. The medic pin. I'm guessing that's the base item for making the medic archetype. Because it's like you get the base item and then you have to like do a step to finish it. And for other archetypes, you would find those base items in the world, but for these ones, you buy the base item. And sure enough, I see it under here and I just don't have enough scrap. It's just the item, luminite crystals, and scrap to turn it into the actual thing. Sniper war metal. Well, since that's the sniper, I'm gonna definitely that's Hunter. So, I guess whenever we do unlock second archetypes, I guess I have Hunter, which is fine. That's a good one. A little bit ironic to combine a long range and a short range archetype, but you know, details. Extra range is most helpful on a short range weapon, though. I will say that. Question is, do I have enough random crap I could sell to get that 1,000 so that I can just like have it and not worry about it? I don't want to sell any like one-time crafting materials.
Yeah.
If I sold 6 luminite crystals, that still didn't even have to craft this and is. Just enough.
Need anything?
Maybe
I'm
Wallace
here.
Will know.
Do the thing, except for some reason it turned red.
New material.
Yeah. So that guy that's like up the tower at the back area.
Mm-hmm.
He's the one that will craft that into the actual thing.
Say that.
Okay.
Right.
So this is what I would wind up crafting.
Yeah, so you're just short on scrap. So we can just come back and do that part, but we'll probably have enough scrap
when
we come
traveler.
Back from the trip that unlocks second archetype, because we don't actually have the slot for it yet. But I did confirm this is in fact Hunter. Their trait increases weapon range. Their prime perk is weak spot damage, although I wouldn't get that if I put it as a secondary. Unlock the second skill for our class, our current archetypes. I was going to switch one into that.
Oh yeah. Companion will follow handler and continuously heal allies within 3.5 meters for 0.25% of max health per second.
Ain't a lot, but yeah, add up.
through with the guard dog one, the initial one that I start with. The howl reduces our damage by 15% to all allies within 20 meters and generates additional threat.
Yeah, you're basically going to choose between tank or healer.
But yeah, howl, the next one, howl grants 2% of max health per second and 25% increased movement speed to all allies.
What did you
for 31 seconds. So it... Yeah, do we take him...
We're
generating threat
here.
And taking hits, which came in clutch in a lot of situations.
Yeah.
Or do we get movement speed buffs?
When you get the medic thing equipped, like, the tank one's definitely better.
Right.
Like, not even a question.
But for right now, support dog may be better.
It's pretty close right now. Like, support dog is would be better for, like, not bosses, and I think guard dog would be better for bosses.
Yeah.
But, like, we kind of get jumped by bosses right now.
When I can, when we're about to go into it, a fight, I can swap between it, right?
Yeah, like if it's an obvious boss, you could like swap it right before you rest, and then it'll refresh it from resting.
Yeah.
All right. I just realized that my Juggernaut skill, like, there's things that increase skill duration.
What do
right?
you?
And there's things that reduce the cooldown. And, like, if I maxed out the skill cooldown, then there would not... It would be more time under Juggernaut than not under Juggernaut.
Yeah.
Which is movement speed and... movement speed, melee damage, and stagger resistance. So you don't get staggered by hits as often. Although the final skill is the real good one. Increased fire rate, increased reload speed, increased movement speed, kills or dealing any significant damage, grant one stack of rage, increasing damage. Upon reaching 10 stacks, you go berserk, which doubles the effect while reloading your current firearm. Just straight up rampage mode. It's actually called rampage, how about that?
I wonder if this concussive shot has anything to do with those, like, phantom hits that you sometimes get, where I'm not...
Oh, like I'm getting grazed by it, but I don't see it?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Which is weird, because a lot of times you're not even on my screen when I do it, but maybe that, like, movement of air, you're detecting something, or getting a few hits of damage or something.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because it deals 155 damage and 4x impact. So you would feel that.
Yeah, it's because it's mostly like a knockdown hit, right?
Right.
I'll swap out this.
Unfortunately, those are my only two.
Yeah, same here.
So,
just,
like...
You just have to kind of deal with it.
What worries me is you've been well off my screen, like, heading back, reloading, and you still will occasionally say, "What the hell hit me?"
Yeah.
So.
I mean, sometimes it's literally just an enemy, like, came in from behind me that...
Yeah, it could be that, too.
Yeah. Because, like, you can't really see very well behind you in this game, so... You see a little bit better if you max out the FOV, but then it looks weird. And it's really not that huge of an improvement on seeing behind you, so... Yeah, I'll just keep it on.